Okay, everyone, so let's do some meditation together again. As always, just start out with the standard way of just making sure that you relax properly, that you are at ease, and that you are enjoying yourselves. So you start off in a good way, and then the meditation can continue on from there in a nice way. So feel your body, allow yourself to relax and to be at ease, and then gradually allowing mindfulness to arise. and to really be able to relax properly, the attitude is so important. Always make sure that you just nudge the mind a little bit in the direction of right attitude. A sense of just feeling blessed and lucky to be part of a group like this, having this ability right here in the middle of the city to take part in some meditation practice and hearing these marvelous teachings of the Buddha, and being part of members of a group of good people, like-minded people, who are also doing something positive. What a wonderful thing that is. And in this way, see if you can take the sense of peace and meditation to a deeper level. you are ready and you feel your mind is relatively clear and calm, let's try to take the meditation in a slightly different direction. And only do this if you feel at ease and comfortable with it. But first of all, just imagine yourself. Imagine yourself in a room somewhere, in a room that is very simple. The walls are all white, the ceiling is white, there's a bed in the room, with an ordinary mattress and with a white sheet over it. And you are lying on this bed with just a simple white garment on you, like a hospital garment or something like that. And there's no windows in the room, the door is closed, there's no sounds anywhere, there's nothing to see in this room, it's very, very simple. You're lying on this bed, you're lying on your back, and you know that the last few hours of your life have arrived, and you will not be seeing anyone else between now and the time of your final passing away. So what does it feel like, lying on this bed, knowing that your death is very nearby? Just take note of that feeling, what it feels like, and I will come back to that later on. But for now, just keep in mind this image of just lying on a bed on your back in a very simple room. There's nothing of interest in this room whatsoever. There's no window. There's just four white walls and a white ceiling, and that is all there is. The door is closed. And you will not be seeing anyone at all from now until the time you finally pass away. And remember to make this realistic. One day it is going to be like this, and now is the time to prepare for that, to make sure you go through this process in the right way. And you are now getting closer and closer to your death. Just keep that image in your mind for a few moments. And as you are lying there, you start to to realize that you are going to have to leave this world behind. Everything that belongs to this world is going to have to be left behind. And some of the most obvious things that you're going to have to leave behind are all your possessions in this life. Everything you have ever owned or you are still owning now is going to have to go. And just feel what it feels like to let go of all of those things, knowing that you're moving on away from all this. And it is as if you have this feeling that all of these are things in your life that don't really belong to you anymore. And perhaps they never really belonged to you in the first place. Because they don't belong to you, you just have to give them up. And it's not just the physical belongings in your life, but also all the friends and acquaintances and even spiritual friendships that you have made in this life. All those people will now have to go. You know you cannot control the situation, and you have to say goodbye to all these people in your life. And it is not just your friends and acquaintances, but all your family members, all the people that have been closest to you during this lifetime, they will also all have to go. You wish them well, may you all fare on in safety and in happiness, but now is the time to say goodbye. and try to feel what it feels like to be giving up so much. As you give things up, it is as if you start to feel this peaceful sense of emptiness inside, a beautiful sense of emptiness. There's nothing there to hold on to, nothing to attach to, a sense of free emptiness within. And see the how the giving up of things lead to this beautiful feeling inside her. You are getting closer and closer to your final passing away. And as you're getting close, it becomes so obvious that everything that belongs to this world has to go. And you start to realize that so much of your identity, of who you take yourself to be, is tied up with this world. Your social status, your academic achievements, your position in the network of society, whatever it is that you identify with, your wealth, your all of these things, your gender, your nationality, whatever it is, all of these things are only meaningful in this world. Now, when you're moving on, all of these things have to go. Feel how nice it is to empty out all of these limiting qualities that we carry with us. see if you can feel that sense of emptiness, a sense of liberation that comes from giving up so many of these identifiers. In the end, when we give up this world, we give up so much. And actually, what a wonderful thing that is. And the moment of your passing away is getting very close now. You're almost coming to that point. And you realize one of the last things that you have to let go of is your physical body. See what it feels like to let go of the physical body. You are gradually becoming this disembodied spirit, just like a mind without any physical body. All you are carrying with you is the good qualities in your heart, the good qualities in your mind that you bring with you into the future. The sense of peace, the sense of emptiness, the sense of compassion and kindness that you take with you into the future. Comes a point in this process, you're not really sure whether you are dead or alive, but you realize it doesn't really matter. You realize it's almost like there's something false about the idea of death and living in this way. Instead, you just feel free. You feel free of so many burdens that you carried with you for so long. The sense of emptiness inside, sense of moving on into the future, with all these wonderful qualities you have developed, and how nice it is. And you wonder why you were ever afraid of dying when it's such a beautiful process. There's few things in life that you have ever experienced quite as nice as this. tender as you are moving away from your earthly existence, feeling peaceful and empty inside. You start to feel a sense of gratitude, a gratitude in your heart for having had an opportunity to live life well, for having had a support from the world that is now left behind. You feel a sense of gratitude for all the Kalyanamitas, to the Dhamma, to the Buddha, and all these wonderful things that have made this beautiful ending of life possible. And you see the planet Earth in your mind's eye, this beautiful planet with green and blue and white, and you wish all the beings there, all these beautiful friends and Kalyanamitas from everywhere around the whole globe, and any other beings there might be, you wish them all well. Thank you for your companionship over this life. Thank you for being my spiritual friends. May you all fare on in happiness and well-being. then spread that kindness, that well-wishing, spread it out to the whole universe, in all the four directions, beings that are visible and invisible. And there are so many beings in this universe with wonderful and beautiful hearts and minds. What a wonderful thing it is to share the universe with so many wonderful beings. May all the beings out there, may you all be well, may you all be happy. Now just very gently come back to your breath again, and just stay with your breath for a few moments. Ask yourself how you feel now, and if you feel more at ease, more relaxed, more positive in one way or another, then ask yourself why that is the case. Try once again to understand the causality of this experience we call meditation practice. Okay, so that is the meditation for now. So please just continue. Have a nice lunch. And we'll see you again at 1:30 this afternoon.